So let's talk about who is most at risk for this. Is this genetic? Is it age related?
So I guess you could take that question and turn it around another way, which is what causes aneurysms?
Perfect. Right? Okay.
And when we think about what causes aortic aneurysms, the truth is we don't really know. We know that there are several factors that are precursors or that increase your risk of having an aneurysm. Perhaps the most important one is family risk. So if someone in your family, a father or a mother, a sibling, has had an aneurysm, we know that that's a very, very strong link. It tends to be more common in men, but not exclusive in men. And this genetic linkage is pretty strong, actually. We're actually doing research now at Miami Cardiac and Vascular Institute, along with our genomics department, to actually try and discover the gene that's linked to aneurysm, because over the past 30 years of treating these patients, we actually have a number of families, and we have a research project going on now trying to discover that gene, in which perhaps we'd be able to get some sort of a biomarker, ultimately a blood test, basically, to predict whether the patient has an aneurysm. But for today, we have to work with other risk factors. So family history is important. If you smoke, your risk of having an aneurysm is increased. We know they don't cause aneurysms, but the risk of having an aneurysm is increased, and particularly if you're a smoker, the risk of mortality if your aneurysm ruptures if you're a stroker is, if you're a smoker, is much higher. Other risks include age, generally these aortic aneurysms occur over the age of 55. So actually CMS in the United States has approved one-time screening, generally with ultrasound of the abdomen, for patients in the Medicare age group over 65 who have a history of smoking, and that'll be part of CMS coverage. But that represents a small population, really, from a screening point of view.
And what is CMS, doctor, if you could clarify?
I'm sorry.
No problem.
CMS is our Medicare delivery agency of the government.
Okay, very good.